Support for the Nature Museum is provided by Rose Pest Solutions, protecting homes, businesses, health, and the environment since 1860.
Hello, everyone, and welcome back to Curious by Nature. My name is Annabelle, and today we're going to take a closer look at one of my all-time favorite animals, snakes. We get lots of great questions about snakes from our museum visitors, such as, how do snakes find food? And how do snakes find a mate? Snakes are able to do all of those things and more because of their sense of smell and their scent trailing ability. What is scent trailing, you may ask? Well, let's join Aaron and Lelania to find out.
Lelania, what are we doing today?
We're gonna look at snake scent trailing today.
Awesome, and what is scent trailing for a snake? What does that mean?
Well, you see the snake is flickering its tongue, and that's how it gets information about its environment. And when a snake scent trails, it might be looking for a mate, it might be a younger snake following older snakes to a place for hibernation or brumation, and it might be hunting for food. So today what we're gonna see is a snake scent trailing for prey. So snakes use their tongue to get information about the environment. And so what they do is they get molecules from the air, and they have a special organ called a Jacobson's organ, and that helps them to know what is around them.
So they almost taste smells.
Yeah.
That's very cool. And Elena, who are we working with today?
We're working with Toby. Toby is a fox snake.
So we're looking at almost a maze. What exactly is this?
It is a maze, and it's shaped like a T. And what we're going to do is get one snake scent going this way to the left. And then when we put the other snake, we're going to let the snake decide which way to go and look at if he decides to go where the other snake went. We're going to place Toby into the maze, and we're going to guide him the way we want so that he leaves a scent in here, and then we'll see later if the other snake will follow that. So you can see that Toby has chosen the side he wanted to go to, and he's moving. We're letting him move around a little bit so he can leave a little bit more scent on this side. We have just allowed Toby to go through the maze to leave his scent. I'm going to return Toby to his enclosure, and we're going to meet the next snake in just a minute.
So we have a second snake for our scent trailing. Who's our second snake, and why do we have two snakes for this exercise?
This is Fang. Fang is a California king snake. His coloring isn't like most that you'll see in the wild. He's albino. And the reason we're using a different snake is that king snakes eat other snakes. And as I mentioned before, we're looking at scent trailing for looking for prey. He likes to eat snakes, so we're gonna see if he catches that scent and follows it. Now we're gonna put Fang into the maze and see if Fang picks up on the fox snake scent. Let's see if Fang picks up the scent trail. And remember that Toby took a right. So we saw Fang actually ended up following that scent all the way to the end, following where Toby the fox snake went. Fortunately, we had put Toby away.
That's so interesting. So snakes use scent to find a mate, follow older snakes to places they would overwinter, and even to hunt. That's awesome. Thank you, Lulania, and thank you to Toby and Fang for showing off their smelling skills with us.
That's our show for today. We hope you learned something new about snakes and scent trailing. If you have any questions about snakes, please be sure to drop them in the comments below. In the meantime, if you want to learn more about these really awesome critters, we've picked out these videos for you. If you enjoyed today's video, please be sure to like and subscribe so you never miss an episode. We'll see you next time on Curious by Nature.